behind the station yards, well out of homestead sight. It was there I camped in fitful sleep and passed away the night. It was just a drafty bowshed, all walled in hessian sack. 'Twas Kelly's country kitchen out on the Wavell track. By that grimy old smoke alley, the ringers met at night and sat and yarned for hours, hell, and some of them could skite. Of broncs and spearhorn mickeys that they'd rode and that they'd thrown, and stories that they'd heard of would soon be made their own. Old Kelly Hardy was the bloke with license there to kill, but made full well that every night each ringer ate their fill. He ran the camp at Mambolo when times were rather grim, and nearly died on the Murrinjay, but luck had stuck with him. With a dishcloth wipe and in a blur and a rollie in his mouth, he'd tell of the time he hit the track and humped his way down south. When carving up the brownie, mate, he'd spit upon the ground, then tell the tale of Lassiter's Reef that he had nearly found. Bought a twinkle to his one good eye to hear the young bloke skite of the blues that they had been in, yet never lost a fight. Now you may hear some tall bush yarns from blokes near Pepperminardi, but these few words I'll have you know I wrote for Kelly Hardy. Old Kelly was our camp cook, number one on Campfield Station. In the territory back in 86, stirs up your imagination. Ah, he'd have to have been the best damn cook we struck in the territory, but with a tendency to handle truth a little bit carelessly. Now you may hear some tall bush yarns from blokes near Pepperminardi, but these few words I'll have you know I wrote for Kelly Hardy. Yeah, these few words I'll have you know I wrote for Kelly Hardy. Odelay, 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 hi.